Hare Krishna. Even if we are feeling miserable, that doesn't give us the right to make others miserable. Misery loves company, it is said. But that doesn't mean that it is the right thing. When we feel miserable because of whatever reason, then it's so easy to just get carried away by that, to start feeling sorry for ourselves, and then start having such a long face and become sullen, uncommunicative, or irritable. And then what happens by that? We start making people around us miserable. We live in an interconnected world, and every time one person is in a bad mood, actually, that makes people around them also disturbed. At the very least, other people have to walk on very tender feet. They have to be very, very hyper conscious. They become stressed. And sometimes one person's bad mood, it rubs off on others, and others also start going into a bad mood. And then both of them quarrel with each other, and it just escalates and makes everyone's life miserable. So whether it is a family, whether it is a workplace, whether it is some other social setting, we all have a responsibility to be happy. We live in a world where we always think about our rights. But suppose somebody is in a bad mood, then what happens? If we change the situation, while we would be understanding, yes, something bad has happened, it's understandable that somebody might be in a bad mood. But that doesn't mean that what they're doing is pleasant. And especially if after going through distress, somebody stays calm and composed, then that evokes others' admiration and appreciation. This person is made up of stern stuff. They have character, they have spine. So each of us has a responsibility to strive to be happy. That doesn't mean we deny the problems that are there in our life. That it simply means that we don't obsess over the problems, we don't publicize the problems. Rather, if we have a service attitude, that okay, whatever situation I am in, how can I best serve? If we start thinking about others and think that our emotions are going to make others, are going to affect others' emotions, if we start thinking about how we can serve others, how we can help others, we get our thoughts out of ourselves, then we'll find that actually we will start feeling better. When we try to make others better, whether we succeed or not in that, we make ourselves better. Now, there are cautionary notes here. First is that it's not that we want to put on a mask, a facade. We do need people with whom, if we are burdened, we should be able to unburden ourselves. But having done that with some close people, we need the ability, the resilience to move on. Not that one bad thing has happened and for weeks and months and maybe years we keep complaining and wailing about it. We need to be tough enough to heal from it and move on. And of course, when we want to make others better, that is not in a judgmental sense, that moralistic sense, but rather we just want to serve, we want to help, we want to assist. And as soon as we get the thoughts out of our problems and our feelings, we'll find that we'll start feeling better. The Bhagavad-Gita says that happiness is an austerity of the mind. In 16 and 17, the Gita talks about austerity of body, speech, and mind in 17, 14, 15, and 16. So 17, 16 says, Manah prasada saumyatvam maunam atmavinigraha bhava samshuddhiritye tattapomanasamuchyate. Tapomanasamuchyate. That this is the austerity of the mind. Just as physical austerity makes the body stronger, mental austerity makes the mind stronger. When we do the austerity of manah prasad, of staying cheerful, then we'll find that our mind will become tougher to resist life's adversities and the negative moods that are triggered by it. and thus we will become stronger. So thus by making the austerity to be happy, by doing that austerity, we will make ourselves happier and put ourselves on the path to be happy. And if you look from a spiritual perspective and understand that God is in charge, that Krishna can bring good even out of the bad, and if we survive the bad and move closer to Krishna through the bad, then we are definitely on the path to a better life. Thank you. Hare Krishna.